What do you do when you have no appointments at all during a day? Well, for me, this is a first in a long time. I'm not sure what I'm going to do. Probably edit my course a little bit more. Go through EA, Expert Academy from Brennan Burchard, EA10. I think I'm going to make a little ride on my bike and go for a walk without my crutches to the restaurant nearby, so I have some exercise done. Well, the thing is, we changed clocks as in about 2 weeks ago, and it's really turning into fall, which means it's dark, and I really have to get used to that. So it feels a little bit weird. You know, one moment it's still daylight and the next moment it's dark and cold and a little bit, it's not foggy, it's not wet, but it's damp. That's probably the best way to describe it, even though it's not even raining, but most of the days it is. So, I guess I'm looking for people to go on an IG live with me, and on the other hand I'm like, just going to see what I'm going to do. It's such a rare day without any obligations. Well, if we could talk about an obligation, maybe send them in at 2 at night for me, but that's about it. You know, I have the time to finally switch my SIM card to this new phone instead of doing IG Reels or IG Lives from the old one with a kind of foggy face. And well, I'll talk to you later. I had quite a good catch today going to the store, Too Good To Go. So it's the Spar, but they have a Too Good To Go package. So let's see what's in there. There's watermelon, more watermelon. There's bread in there, and you don't know this, but I'm allergic to malted barley extract. So I need the white stuff unless I'm in the US, because then malted barley extract is actually in there. It's a flavor for salt, flavor replacement juice. What you didn't see was I also had a sandwich with cheese. Then this one, I don't know what you call those. You call them quintabella with cheese, like those two. And then there's more. That's my hot meal. For those who do not know, I have problems with cooking. There's another one because I can't stand up for a long time. And also, this is not a place to do it. And some egg salad. Always nice. And this one I bought. This is my favorite snack of the day. It's an oatmeal cookie. So, you know, for €5, so a little over $5, that's quite a good catch. Time to move on, because I ran out of beverages, soy milk, coconut milk, almond milk, and orange juice. So I'm going to get that, because that's what I need in order to make my smoothies, because I still have frozen strawberries and mangoes in there. I actually made myself a smoothie earlier today with some protein powder, which I still have. And for my iced coffee, so I use half coconut milk and half water, so it's not so I don't put on too much weight when drinking it, and it still tastes really good. Anyway, going there now. I'm going on my bike. That's good exercise. Actually, when I was in the when I was there at the spa, I did some exercises, which was kind of funny to do. But I realized that it's kind of hard to do when you're doing it holding the camera. So I don't know. No, I'm going to show you later on. Okay, toodles, see you later. Taking advantage for a moment while I was eating my currant bun. I looked it up. So apparently it's bun, currant bun. With cheese, by the way. It does give me a heartburn, so I had to drink some. In this case, it wasn't soy milk, it was almond milk. It's a little bit of coffee. So this one is charging. It's kind of cool. It's an activity tracker. And fortunately for me, I've got a spare one. That's this one. And well, it basically says it's 10 degrees outside. And well, that one is charging, the other one, and my inner ears for on my old phone are charging. I'm going to hop on my bike and go to the macro. Took my supplements as well and my medication. For those who don't know, I've got all these allergies, which is find the way it is, I suppose. and also I've got a shortage of vitamin D. It's cold over here, it's dark most of the time, and part of me is Asian, so I'm always short on vitamin D. It runs in the family, basically. Well, going there, I'm going to put this one on. What I like about it is, besides that it's a tourist thing, it reminds me of Florida, and I totally adore Florida. Okay, talking a bit. That's right, before I forget, we need to wear facial masks again. So there should be one on my crutch, which is attached to my bike, because I do need a crutch in such a big place like the macro. It's sort of like a superstore, but then for people who own their own company. So getting mine and leaving. Later. So, if correct, I only will be needing to show my Corona app check. So basically the QR code with some moving persons underneath, which saves me from the facial mask. But you know, I tend to use the bus when I'm not bringing my facial mask. But I left the facial mask on the crutch because I know me, and I'm so good at forgetting to take it with me if I take it off. They are going to give me hell when I go to the macro and I don't have one. Although they should have some of their own themselves. Well, the idea of using the other watch was fun, but I didn't get the GPS to work. So hopefully it did measure my heart rate going up. And if so, I should be able to pinpoint when I was cycling back and forth and cycling back. So this exercise is a stability exercise for me. It's when I'm on even ground that I usually do not have any problems, unless someone tries to get my attention. It's when I turn around quickly that things go haywire. But if I don't, then I'm actually pretty good nowadays. And lots of people have noticed the change when I'm walking, so that's cool. And something else which is pretty cool. I told you about the vitamin D supplements I've been taking for over a year now. And this year I didn't have to wear my gloves, my leather gloves, during the summer. So, and I still haven't had to use them during the beginning of fall, since it has become colder. Of course, I do walk like this because, yeah, my hands tend to get very cold quickly, and my fingers too. So whereas I'm really feeling kind of hot right now, as you have noticed, I am wearing a t-shirt with long sleeves. And now, yeah, some sort of sweater. It's not very warm, but it does the trick, a hoodie on top of it. But I get warm pretty quickly. Part of it is because I'm overweight, and another part of it is because I'm muscular and I need to be in order to regain balance, because my ligaments are not capable of doing the job on their own when it comes to my joints. So because my ligaments are too flexible, it's very important that I train my muscles. And that's one of the reasons I'm walking. But I still can't tell you how much it means to me to be doing so without my crutches. Yay! That's, you know, that's so immensely cool. So, so the restaurant I'm going to is only open from Wednesday on until Sunday. Well, also on Sunday. And I'm not sure what I'm going to do over there. I did bring my iPad and a notebook. So if I want to, I can write some thoughts down. But I don't think I'm going to be checking out my course or any stuff like that. So what I would be doing, for instance, is edit videos. So I might upload some pictures and videos I recorded earlier today. Not sure yet. Could be. I don't know. You know, yesterday Amen, Dr. Daniel Amen was on Growth Day. He's a brain specialist, which is kind of cool. And, well, he talked about symptoms of people with ADD and ADHD. And, well, I could check all the boxes, basically. So, he said it's about learning skills instead of taking pills, which is a good thing. I do have to admit, I am taking something. It's not very, it's, you know, it basically works like 3 days, so it's not like regular ADHD medicine. It's very mild in comparison. I need to watch where I walk now. But yeah, it does the job. So, and every once in a while, I forget it, which is fine by me, because, okay, it's at less, as at, it's not at such a high dosage, but it's still working on the third day, so that's good. And of course, I have been teaching myself the necessary skills. For instance, like meditation. I'm an excellent daydreamer when it comes down to it. We talked about writing down things you want to remember. I'm excellent at doing so as well. And when I don't have the option, I will ask someone to send me like a text message or something. So I did get good at it. So I can tell that I've been cycling already today. My legs are a little tired, so I have a little bit more problem when it comes to keeping my balance, especially talking to you guys out there. And I don't know, maybe I should have done an IG live. Maybe I will do an IG live when I am on my way back. I don't know. We'll see. Anyway, I'm not going to change this right now. Although I could when crossing the street. We'll see. The one thing about IG lives I do not like is the portrait function, because I always like to upload my videos in YouTube, so that's always a bit of a hassle for me. Yeah, I can't just turn around and go step down. That's one of the disadvantages I have with this knee. But then again, I'm so thrilled and I'm so grateful for Dr. Van Dalen, the surgeon, that she took the time out to listen to me, make the scans, and did do the surgery, the second surgery, which took away basically all my problems. And yeah, you know, there are days and I just can't thank her enough. So being outside, having these allergies, means that basically I'm sniffing right now. I can't help it. It's the way it is. You can tell it's damp by the sound of the electricity poles over here. You don't have wooden poles. They are metal poles over here. That's one of the things I really had to get used to when going abroad, you know, seeing them for the first time. And actually, there are some smaller villages around here, which I didn't know. You have those wooden poles as well. Okay, news to me. I've always grown up in a big city. Where I'm walking right now is quite the opposite of it for me. The funny thing is, though, that The Hague used to be a village too, not because of the amount of people, but because they never asked for the right of a city. So I'm not sure when they started doing so. They must have been doing so at some point, but I have no clue when it was. So I'm going up, in case you're wondering what's going on. Why it's getting a little bit harder. Well, now you know why. So basically, we are crossing the bridge, which I passed going underneath when I was by car. It's the road which goes to the highway and vice versa back to the village. Okay, hang on. Like I said, I'm getting tired. Okay. Almost there. I feel like I'm starting to sway over here. It's nice actually to have a day to myself. There was one person I was going to call. I actually tried twice. He was too busy. We talked on the phone last night. He asked me to call him today, which I did. Well, we'll see when I get to talk to him again. And it's funny because I had a little discussion on the chat with some men about business coming first, that being the golden rule, which of course is true. And the question is, do we always have to let the customer come first? Well, the customer is of course the one who is paying. But what when it comes to promotion? And what if you have several customers who want to be there at the same time? And what if you need to go to the physical therapist? I mean, if I go to the physical therapist, sometimes, rarely, but sometimes I do stay in the car just a tip bit longer, but usually I tell them, I'm sorry, I need to leave now. I'll call you back later. And when I know I have like a coaching call or a group coaching call, like the Growth Day app or that stuff, of course I can always watch it again. But there's something about being there live. I usually try to plan around it, if that's possible. Now yesterday I went to a friend after the Growth Day call had been going on, and I was talking to the client, so I already had parked the car, and then I sent her a message, okay, going to get in a little bit later because I'm still on the phone. So yes, I did put her on hold. But I knew we were going to have an hour, a couple of hours straight after. And so we did. So, I've arrived at the furry hare, the furry rabbit, in under 50 minutes, which is cool. So I'm just going to turn around really quickly. Here it is. And I'll talk to you later. I just listened to Angela talking about resilience, and I put in a request to go live with her, and then I forgot that this phone still doesn't have a SIM card in there. So as much as I would love to join her live, it's just not possible. But in response to what she said, we both are part of the Movement Maker family, which means that I need to change something. Well, I thought I'd try being connected through my other iPhone. Unfortunately, I could see her, but I could not hear her, so that didn't work quite well as I'd wanted to. But well, here I am walking across the bridge, and yeah, when it comes to resilience, this is part of me, of me being resilient and getting back up, learning to walk again without my crutches, after having dealt with my ankle, my left ankle, pleading to get surgeries done. Now, of course, my left knee, which is kind of problematic. My right knee is too, but it's not as bad as my left knee is, fortunately for me. So, the topic about resilience comes from Evan Carmichael. Both Angela and I are part of the Movement Maker family, so... And I believe it is like a family. We actually encourage one another and help one another to get stuff done, so that's cool. And, well, in October, Evan had us, had given us a challenge to do with regards to momentum. And I have to admit, it helped me really to gain momentum. I got a new lead magnet down. I think it was better than one I've done in all this time. And I got my OVO done, which means that if you were watching it, I had you go into an email list. And right now I'm on the verge, well, I actually started already, was offering something, which in this case is coaching, because after all, I am a coach. Yes, I'm a rider too, I'm a trainer too, but I think I'm primarily a coach. I'm curious by nature, and as coach, it's about figuring out what's holding people back. So it definitely feeds my curiosity, and in my case it's also about making connections they can't make themselves about what's happening in their life and what they could possibly change. So it's a little bit dark here. You can handle that for a sec. That's the downside from walking back here with the awesome lighting we have over here. By the way, it's 10 in the evening, just to give you an idea, and I'm a little bit swirling, which of course is the result of me still needing to learn to be more stable again. And of course, I already walked to the restaurant after cycling a little bit. So yeah, I'm a little bit tired. That's called muscle fatigue. I'm not tired in my mind. It's just muscle fatigue. But it was nice to be sitting just now at the regular stable. Yeah, I am a regular over there. It's, you know, it's nearby. And I guess I know most of the menu by heart as well, so that's a good thing. So again, talking about resilience, you know, learning to walk again and being able to do so without crutches is kind of like a challenge for me. I never know what's going to happen next, but and when things were going so well, and then last summer, as in a couple of months ago in June, things went haywire again and I twisted my knee, and well, that was basically the end of stability, and I was like, what now? Surgery? What? And well, we've come up with a brace, and I'm also getting injections which stimulate the cartilage, actually. So it feeds the cartilage. And how do I explain this? Well, in order for a joint to function very well, there is some fluid in there, and that can be, well, it needs to be nurturing, that fluid. And when it's too sticky and there's not enough of it, then we basically notice that because we are really stiff. So there's a name for it. I can't get to the name right now. That's the downside of how my brain is wired. Put me on the spot and I completely forget straight away. But I also know that it will get back in a few minutes and then I'll tell you. So, well, I'm waiting for the brace, and it's got the stars and the stripes on there. I just love stars and stripes, that's me. And it's a little bit weird for Dutch people, because we are really down to earth. We always say, just act normal. And then you're acting weird enough as this. So, yeah. It's going to be visible, but I don't like boring. Okay, so the name of the stuff I was talking about, the fluid, is called synovia. So that's what I meant with that's how my brain works. So, yeah, so resilience is near to my heart. It's about not giving up. It's about, when you have a setback, you still say, okay, you know what? I'm just going for it. And when it comes to the people who I coach, resilience is so immensely important. Because why do people go to a coach? Not only to grow and develop themselves, but it also has to do with how they feel about change they want in their life. And I could probably link this to well, a number of those who have come over to depression, I suppose, and with it to addiction. You know, a lot of people, when they don't feel up to par, so when they're depressed, they're angry, they're upset, yeah, hang in there, there will be light again. They tend to numb themselves. Some people do it by playing video games. Some people do it by binge watching TV. Others do it by drinking a crate of beer, or several ones, or bottles of wine, whatever your choice is. Your choice of poison, I'd say. And then there are a lot of people who start to smoke. Then there are the people who start to eat. Of course, there's something called therapeutic shopping. Sounds nice, therapeutic shopping. But you can't do that forever. Because if you do, you don't have any money left in your bank account. And there's something called drugs. And yeah. All of these have reasons. So when people come and see me, fortunately, not everyone is at that level. But lately, there have been people at that level, and if I don't help them deal with whatever is bugging them, then I know it will end up to, well, you know, how much can you reverse? Can you reverse someone taking their life? Can you reverse your health declining because of, for instance, smoking, not eating very well, drinking a lot? And please, this is no judgment, but you know, when your cardiologist is telling you you're not doing very well, and when you wake up the next day and you're not capable of doing anything at all because you feel so terrible, well, that's definitely a sign on the wall. And quite often it's because people do not know how to express themselves, which is why I give people a voice. And this brings us back to resilience, because in order to be resilient, you either need to be able to talk to yourself, give yourself a pep talk, or explain it to others. Find some sort of community, find some sort of support, so you are not on your own. And you know, writing helps, but express yourself. I guess that would be my main message to you. I'm back again. This is what I wanted to say about resilience. And if you need someone to help you, to coach you, so you can get through the day and especially through life in a way you would love to, as in being happy again, then find me here, right now, on Instagram. And we either do an IG live, or we get a chat, get a free coaching call, or simply register to chikarasc.com/start to speak out now, and I will add that to the description. Okay, I'm back, and I'm hopping on my bike in a little bit. So enjoying my time off. Laters!